You are listening to TF Talk News, part of the TF Talk network of podcasts and live streams, where we give you the most relevant current stories in your fandom and more, all within 30 quick minutes or less. I am your host, Mr. Starscream, and I'll be your guide to everything. Wait a minute. I'm not Mr. Starscream. I'm Deron. This isn't my show. How did I get here anyway? Hello? Man, I just can't stop eating these delicious chips. Discover more of our great shows at tftalk.net and follow us on social media channels at TFYLP.
Hey everyone out there in TF Talk land, this is Sideburn 2. You might not recognize my voice since I haven't been on the TF Talk podcast in a while, but I'm super active in the new TF Talk Discord. You can join in on the fun yourself by visiting bit.ly/TFTalkDiscord. It's free, and the whole team is there yucking it up 24/7. Mr. Starscream invited me to his secret lair for crumpets and tea, but somehow I ended up hosting his podcast instead. Crazy, huh? Sorry. I mean, have you tried these chips? Mr. Starscream gave me a big bag of them, and they're my favorite flavor. Speaking of him, why isn't he here giving this monologue? This is the first double-digit episode of TF Talk News and all, the big 1-0. He promised to have something special in mind, like reviving old segments and creating some new ones. I guess we'll just have to keep listening and see what happens. Excuse me. Sorry. Okay, that's enough blabbing for now, though, because I'm sure everyone wants me to get right into the new Transformers reveals for this week. Sayonara, suckers!
Hi, and welcome to the TF Talk Reveal Spiel. I'm your host, Lucas, the host of TFYLP podcast on Mondays and a regular contributor to Microcaster on Tuesday evenings. There wasn't a ton of juicy stuff this week, but Mr. Starscream is making me do this anyways. Although by now we're all aware of the Super Megatron toy coming as a generation select from Takara Tomy, some new photographs were made available that highlight the fact that this is indeed a triple changer and has an Ultra Megatron mode, although it may not be exactly what we're expecting. Beyond the jet mode we've already seen, there's a tank mode and it sports a triple turret that is hidden inside the super cannon. There's also an alternate Ultra mode face that, from what I can tell, is supposed to represent Megatron's favor, Last Night design. It's unclear if we can expect even more surprises from this toy, but the more that we see, the more super it is indeed. Super Megatron is currently available for pre-order at Hasbro Pulse, but this is your last chance to snag him since the deadline is Tuesday, April 28th, only 2 days from the launch of this episode. Don't be snoozing! According to an official post by Hasbro featuring the Earthrise planet map, Earthrise will be a total of 4 full waves of figures before we move on to the next phase of the War for Cybertron trilogy. I expected there to be 4 waves, but this is the first piece of confirmation about it since pre-orders and reveals that we've currently been shown only consist of figures up to wave 3. That map is quite large and indicates how different size classes of toys make up different sizes of the map respectively. There's a lot of empty space so far on this map according to the graphic, and it's unclear if the map pieces will be included in in-store exclusives or generation selects. Mr. Starscream and I were trying to guess what could be part of the Wave 4 Deluxes, but I'm having trouble remembering what he told me or what he said. I'll have to ask him again next week to see what he knows. For now though, you can check out the map for yourself by following Transformers Official on Instagram, or visit the official Transformers Facebook page. No one actually collects the maps though, except maybe Peter, so don't worry about it too much. And in some absolutely explosive Transformers news, I am proud to be the first to inform you that shoebox collectors can finally rest easy because the go-to store China has announced a partnership with Transformers to bring you special collector's edition Transformers acrylic shoeboxes. Shoeboxes? Really? Does this even count as Transformers news? Seriously, who wrote them? I guess if you need some special boxes to put your Transformer boxes in, then this is for you, but it's not my thing. I think that's for me. I'm done here. Actually, how do I get out of here? Where am I anyway? Last thing I remember, I was tasting some delicious crunchy chips, and now I'm part of this weird TF Talk News podcast. I'm going to find my way out of this maze and make Sean read the next segment because I've had enough. Hello? Anyone home? Hey, Mr. Starscream! How are you doing? Hey, wait, what's with that laser blaster?
This is Sean, in for our regular host, Mr. Starscream, who is probably busy packaging junk food, so I've stepped up to bring you the on-the-shelf report this week. The elusive and hard-to-find Siege Rat Bat and Rumble appears to be getting a restock this spring, with late pre-orders appearing on Entertainment Earth and other websites. This set appeared at approximately 3 physical stores in the USA, so if you're looking for it, this is your last chance to stop snoozing. Masterpiece MP10 Atmos Duck Camo Convoy is still available on the Atmos Tokyo web store with an apparent price drop of about $20. It appears that being unable to sell this in store due to COVID-19 concerns has left this exotic redeco of MP10 gathering dust in the Atmos warehouse. So if you've been on the fence, you can now shave a few bucks off this rare item. Just make sure you ship it via DHL, or you can expect to be waiting at least a month because of the EMS backlog in Japan. And as far as stuff on physical shelves, well, you might as well pretend there's nothing out there. It's better to stay safe than sorry, my friends. However, my shelves are looking pretty sweet right now. Not a speck of dust on them. I'm fully stocked, but sorry, folks, nothing is for sale. Wait, where did this bag of chips come from? And now, TF Talk News presents an all-new segment starring cast members Christian and Sergio. Toodaloo.
And 3, 2, 1.
Sergio Christian in the morning. And we're back.
We're here this morning with our guest, Mr. Starscream.
The enigmatic Mr. Starscream.
Also known as Mr. Scream, or as I like to call him,
Hey guys, I'm pretty sure my lawyers told you not to use my real name. You better scrub that.
Oh, there's no one around here to scrub anything. In fact, we aren't even recording.
You're what?
And I think it's time to go to TFYLP correspondent Jim with the weather.
Looks like you can expect intermittent acid rain throughout the next week, but at least the weather in my house feels pretty good.
Wow, that was really captivating, Jim. Thank you for that report.
What report? Seriously, we're trying to put on a real podcast here, guys.
That shattered podcast, you mean, right?
Oh dear, my whole world is turning upside down. My world is transformed.
Do you even have microphones? This is exactly why I left the TF Source YouTube channel. No infrastructure at all.
Speaking of structure, it's time to show this week's
Featured Transformers Custom Artist.
Stop! No one actually likes custom Transformers. You've literally destroyed the toy after you start painting it. You took it out of the box. You did your fancy little stuff. I just can't take it anymore, guys. No one wants a custom Transformer.
Well, that's one opinion.
I'm not sure we'd have this guy back on the show.
Show? This is my show. Open your mouths, you protoform toy collectors. It's time to stuff your face with Mr. Starscream's Hypno-Chips. And if you think you can make your own show without microphones or scripts, I've got a thing or two to show you.
I think it's time to maybe take a word from our sponsors.
You guys got sponsors?
Yeah, that's right. We have a brand new sponsor this week, all the way from Cybertron, and it'll leave you
feeling delirious.
Indeed. After the commercial break, we'll bring you Anna with the thirdest of party news.
And someone that says they own Hasbro is waiting in the wings of our studio.
Of course. All hail Starscream.
Hail Starscream. And Bop-Bots.
Looking for a tasty snack? Need further sustenance for your feeble biological bodies? Well, quit your grinning and drop your linen, because the ultimate snack has finally been fabricated by Cybertron's and Earth's greatest scientific minds. Mr. Starscream's Hypno Chips are a carbon-based snack food, fully digestible by the human body and able to flow through anyone's gastrointestinal tract. This claim has been fully corroborated by the experts at Arkaville Labs, so don't worry, they're safe and delicious. Samples are limited, but you can get some at any Decepticon outpost near you. Mr. Starscream's Hypno Chips. Blissful to your taste buds, and they'll have you under his, their control. Mr. Starscream's Hypno Chips. For sale. Buy today. Payment processed by Bitcoin and are subject to a 27.5 service fee. No bro fans need to apply.
Welcome to the actual third-party news, reported, for once, by someone that actually appreciates the wonderful wild world of non-official transforming action figures. And if a microcasters, that's me, is here to improve upon the third-party news reporting usually offered by our MIA ghost hosts. I've selected a handful of figures that are coming down the third-party pipes that you need to know about this week. Generation Toy Red Bull seems to be almost shipping. No, this isn't some transforming skinny energy drink can. It's a full-fledged beast version of everyone's favorite common but rarely important red car guy, Sideswipe. Red Bull has traded in his tires for hooves and now sports a robotic beast mode as an articulated mechanical bull. Photos of this peculiar release have been circulating for months, but reports are coming in that it should be in the hands of pre-order holders very soon. We'll keep you posted as more of these beast versions of G1 favorites are revealed. In other extremely related Generation Toy news, photos of a white version of the Generation Toy Gorilla, a techno beast version of Optimus Primal, hit the net. This all-white ultra paint scheme features silver chrome parts and will be a must-have for Magnus fans. Available for pre-order now at the usual suspects. New Age finally shared new pictures of the long-awaited XM1 Mista. Contrary to the belief that he would be the legend skill New Age is known for, he's turned out to be a full MP-sized duder, complete with Laserbeak and Ravage. The proportions on this version of Dark Drift of the Moon Soundwave are very human-like, and we have a very clean figure with little non-canonical kibble. In addition to their steady stream of Seeker repaints, New Age also released pictures of their Brawn and Outback in clear Jolly Rancher-styled colors. Speaking of Jolly Ranchers, I'm feeling a bit famished and think I'll take a nibble on these chips I found lying around in the studio. Wait, what studio? Speaking of legends, and when am I not, there is some news from Magic Square. First, they have released pictures of a shining Magnus, clear gold repaint of their Ultra Magnus. They also seem to be ready to ship their take on Ghostbusters Prime using their Legend Scale Optimus Prime mold. But, in actual new news, they have finally released pictures of their own take on the Coneheads. Sporting truly inspired names like Engine, Assault, and Parrish, this fearsome threesome is the remold you would expect given Magic Square's original Seeker mold. There are some unique choices on the wings, and you can be sure that these will have Magic Square's signature washed-out look. Though many owners and reviewers have given the Magic Square Seeker unfavorable reviews compared with New Age's version, I personally prefer them for their animation-accurate look and clean presentation. I have been told both that I strive to be different and that I'm a Magic Square fangirl, so let's make this Anna's Pick of the Week, even though the other two announcements are obviously more exciting. Thank you for listening, and be sure to check in on me and the other microcasters on the TF Talk Facebook page every Tuesday night at 8:30 p.m. Central for the only live group consensus Transformers toy reviews on the net. At least I think we're the only one. Who knows? Ugh, I am not sure these snacks are agreeing with me. I will leave you with my final Anna tip of the week. Next time a robot in a cheap suit hands you a bag of glowing green potato chips, maybe call the authorities before you throw them in your homemade trail mix. Ugh. Seriously, who would put chips in their trail mix? Who wrote this script?
Hi everybody, I am the Rick Alvarez, yes, the notorious one and only Rick Alvarez, and today I am here to reincarnate a segment we'd like to call The One That Got Away. Now you might have heard this segment before when I talked about that G1 power cycle trailbreaker that got away from me. Well, we're bringing this section back because I would say somewhat of a holy grail has recently popped up on eBay. This holy grail is that very infamous, notorious, dubious even, Generation 2 Protectobots Defensor. It never came out. We didn't even get a Combiner Wars G2 Defensor. But, for the first time ever, in public, a complete loose G2 Defensor with all the pieces to form him into Defensor. All five Protectobots are there. And the starting price, get this, $35,000. That's US dollars, by the way. Now, this is listed as a prototype. I would say it's not quite a prototype. It's a production sample or pre-production sample because there are numerous editions of the Protectobots from G2 carded. I've handled these before. Some of them are in the Hasbro vaults. Some of these have made them out into the public. And there are numerous loose Protectobots from G2 out in the public. Sometimes these things can fetch anywhere between $5,000 to $6,000 a piece. Here they are together, $35,000. The seller of this particular rare gem is none other than our friend, extraordinary G1 dealer, I Am Ratchet Toys. He's a great guy. I Am Ratchet Toys has a great reputation for selling AFA graded vintage toys for over a decade. I highly recommend him. Super trustworthy. This guy knows his stuff. Where he gets his stuff, I don't know. So, Mr. Starscream, he reached out to me personally. He asked me to do this segment for him, and he contacted I Am Ratchet for some more clarification on this rare piece and found out the following from the seller himself. This adventure set was purchased from a former Hasbro employee. I wonder if I know him or her. It was intended to be a final hard copy, perhaps a sale sample. It is only one of two complete defensors with all parts and stickers applied. The authenticity of this piece is legit. Again, as a trusted seller, and these items have shown up before. You may remember, it was a few years ago, the G2 Stunicon set, also unreleased, sold on eBay for about $27,000. So, what do you think? 35 grand? Too much? Not enough? Or just right? If you're looking to add a certain piece to your collection, buy pieces of rare plastic that turn into an orange mess of South Florida colors. eBay, G2 Defensor, I Am Ratchet. Type it up, you'll find it. Well, now that that's out of the way, let's move on to something a bit more serious. Something like me, the R.I.K. Rick, a.k.a. Galvarez. A lot of people don't know this, but back in 1982, while living in Northwest Chicago, down in Detroit, in the Northwest region of South Florida, we were sharing a little condo. My roommates were Piers Morgan and Hannah Montana. One night, while getting drunk on an Indian bottle of whiskey, we came up with an idea. Now, I don't know if we came up with the idea as much as the whiskey that we had purveyed from India was affecting my mental stability. The items around my apartment started to convert from a tape deck to robots. And that's how I came up with Transformers. Yes, I am that Rick Alvarez, former brand director and vice president of Hasbro and purveyor of fine whiskeys. I've written at least 7,000 books and I've created worlds that you can't possibly imagine, nor could I. And yes, I'm recording this from my dungeon filled with plastic crack. I'd like to invite you all to listen to Cut the Tape on Friday. That's when I take my plastic crack and take my knife and I open that and I see what's inside the packaging. Mr. Starscream asked me to take some time out of my very busy schedule of doing nothing in quarantine in order to be able to talk to you about this show. That's right. Mr. Starscream. Starscream? Starscream. I think that's how you pronounce it, actually. A lot of people don't know this. Anyway, Fridays, usually Saturday mornings, depending on what time Lucas wakes up, you can catch Cut the Tape. Watch me open a vintage toy, sometimes a new toy, sometimes I just play with Legos. By the way, does anyone really want to know what Mr. Starscream's true identity is? Because I know. It's Lucas.
Rick? What happened, man? Guess the Hasbro police must have finally silenced him for good. Well, since I appear to be the only one left, I'm just gonna have to finish this show myself. The TF Talk Network exists due to the efforts of an enthusiastic collection of Transformers fans across North America and beyond. Check out our variety of shows like Microcasters, Ouch My Wallet, Cut the Tape, and our flagship show featuring a rotating ensemble cast, TFYLP, which has been running for over 10 years. The cast at the TF Talk Network is always growing, so if you have a desire to participate, reach out to us via any of our social platforms at TFYLP. The TF Talk cast is on Discord. You can join us for free by typing bit.ly/TF Talk Discord in the browser of your choice. Intro and outro score provided by Surrender. You can find Surrender at surrender-official.bandcamp.com. Directly support our shows and keep us on the air by becoming a monetary supporter of TFYLP on Patreon. Donations through Patreon are used to cover production and server expenses that keep our shows running and are not distributed to individual staff members. If you have any comments or feedback, you can email the show at tftalknews@tftalk.net. But we all know no one cares. Only boomers use email. Duh, Mr. Starscream. Only people that eat these nasty hypno chips would send him any emails.
Show you, Robert Simmons, host of Ouch My Wallet. I bet that one hurt a little more than an overdrafted bank account, now didn't it? At last, my evil scheme worked. I turned the entire TF Talk staff into mindless slaves to do my bidding with my powerful hypno-chip snack foods. It only took me 10 episodes to perfect them, but I'm fast approaching my total domination of this mudball. Beware, flesh creatures. Soon you will cower under the foot of your new leader, Mr. Starscream. Kremzeeks? No! They've gotten into the entire supply of hypnochips! Ugh, weeks of work wasted. I guess I'll have to go back to hosting this thing myself. Well, see you next week, fleshlings.